Our next speaker, ladies and gentlemen, is the co-founder and CEO of Hector Beverages, the makers of PaperBoat drinks, which, as we all know, is a brand of traditional Indian beverages that, in a very short span of time, has built such a great emotional connect with the audience through its multimedia campaign, digital, of course, being at the core of it. So it's time for us to listen to the story that bridges the gap between ancient wisdom and the convenience of technology. Yes, it's time for us to learn the PaperBoat journey. Please help me welcome our keynote speaker, co-founder, CEO of Hector Beverages, Mr. Neeraj Kakkar.
I was 10 years old, growing up in North India, very small town. The district is Karnal. Our place, the tehsil was Asand. It's a very small rural place, like there were around 5,000 people there. And we had this, you know, we were, see, in front of our houses, there were like, you know, circle of houses, and there was a ground nearby. So it was a plain, barren ground. Like in our side, the grass is not as common, like it's more, you know, so it's a plain, barren ground. Every day afternoon, we will go out and play cricket. And every day afternoon, like this, you know, you make a wicket, this three brick, one brick, three brick, one brick. So you start playing cricket. And then every day when you go out, there was this feeling that, can I go out and hit six sixes today, you know? And then can I go out and take all the wickets, like get everybody out? And I was not a good cricket player. But then every day there was this feeling that, can I become a superhero? Can I go and make my team win the game? And that thing of trying to become a superhero continued all through the journey. Like, you know, there was this thing ki main Haryana board mein first aa jaunga. There was this thing ki main koi chor aayega gaon mein usko pakad lunga. Aur nehar mein, saath mein nehar hai, wahan pe mere dost doob rahe hain, main unko bacha lunga. And I did not know swimming. So things like those continued, and this feeling of, can I be a superhero? Like that whole thing of your childhood goes through this feeling. Then at some stage, thank you. Some stage you start feeling that this superhero thing is not possible. Like, you know, I cannot be, the life sets on, the cynicism sets in, ye nahi ho sakta hai. And you have to do whatever you have to do. And then we started this after a lot of journey from, you know, that small village to wherever it took me. We started this company which makes PaperBoat drinks. And what do we do? And this is how we see ourselves. This is our job. Like, you know, everybody describes his job differently. We describe our job as like this. So we are probably the only people who can say with very high confidence that if I am not there, 30 years down the line, Ampanna would not exist. So between Ampanna's extinction and this like world out there, like I am the only one standing. And that gives you a lot of responsibility and a lot of happiness. Like every single day, like, and you get paid for it also. But every single day, you come home, you have this like superhero clock, like you put it in behind your, like, you know, the door. And then you walk in, because I have done all day, like spent all day saving Ampanna from extinction, or many more drinks like this. And that's how we define ourselves. So somehow, after a journey which is almost like 30 odd years, I started believing in this whole concept of, we can be superheroes. Like, we have to find our own cause, but we can be superheroes. So that's our, that's how we define ourselves. The reason why we started this company is the food philosophy we believe in, that the food travels. Like, food doesn't stay in one place. If the food is good, and it's an evolution in food, like food travels from one place to another. Pulao is, like, I'll give you an example of pulao. Like, somewhere around 5000 BC, like long time back, like for the first time, somebody in Central Arab area first time made pulao. Like, imagine going yourself there. It's very, very harsh condition. Used to be very tough. It's like there were two, you know, rivers, and somebody started making, you know, growing rice there and started making pulao for the first time. But this dish traveled, and if you trace the journey of pulao, like it is the journey of this world. This dish traveled from one place to another. It traveled with Alexander. It traveled with on the Silk Route. It travels in Spain. When it's different names in different parts of the world. Paella, pulav, pilaf, everything. But basically, the food migrates from one place to another. And I'll give you some examples closer to home. So Golgappa is a pretty much North Indian thing. And first time I went to Bangalore, I live in Bangalore now. First time I went to Bangalore in 1998, there was no Golgappa to be had anywhere. Like there was like one, two small shop. But right now, in front of every supermarket, there is this guy who is selling this Golgappa. And you know, you go and ask this guy, first thing which he'll say is Kannada Gotila. Like, I don't know Kannada. Most of these people are from UP and Bihar. And who's selling Golgappa there. And then they say that, no, not only North Indians, but South Indians are also consuming Golgappa. So this you know, the food is, as people migrated from North India to Bangalore for the obvious IT boom, they took Golgappa along with them and started becoming part of the mainstream there. Another example closer to home is momos in Delhi. Like, I presume there's some people from Delhi here. In 1991, when I was visiting Delhi for the first time, the only two places you get momos is Chanakya Puri and Kamla Nagar. Like, they were like the only two places. But now the Bikaner wala sweets wala guy is also selling momos there. And momos, mereko lagta hai ki bread pakode se jada hot snack hai Delhi ka aaj ka. So, and that's some doing, because I think the food migrates, and that's the core of our thing, that food migrates. And there's some companies which make this food migrate faster, and these start becoming more. Pizza is this example. Like in 1930s, it was not even a very big dish in Italy also. It was part of Neapolitan region, very small. People migrated from there to Harlem. They took pizza along with them, single Italian guys. And they, you know, very difficult for them to cook, so pizza cooking was easy. And then it started becoming a big dish for New York, and then, you know, a couple of companies took it international. So I think, that's what we're trying to do in food, you know, take food from one place to another. And there are two core part of our brand, PaperBoat as a brand. One is alive, and second is authentic. So alive is easier to explain, and I will talk about that first, and spend rest of the talk on authentic, which is probably a more difficult thing to execute. Alive for us is contemporary, cool, today, modern, youthful, fashionable. If we would not have made our brand alive, then it has a risk of becoming something like, you know, Chyawanprash or something, you know, which youth would not like consume it. Like, so it's the first time when we launched it in airlines, it was a tough challenge for us. Whether, you know, what are you competing? You're competing in Coke Zero, but you're competing with the aura of Coke Zero there. And whether somebody sitting in an aircraft would order a Jaljeera over a Coke Zero, and you know, that's the challenge in front of you. So you have to make your brand very contemporary and cool and modern for people to accept it in a social setting. But I think the tougher part which is there is the authentic part, which is very, very difficult to produce as well as communicate. Like, how do you communicate that I am authentic? By saying that I am authentic, it's not like nobody's going to believe you. So you have to keep your campaign, your brand focused in a certain direction when you communicate authenticity through. And we chose innocence and childhood to show, or memories to show our authenticity. And there are some examples of that as we go along today evening. So can we have the video, please?
चली बैल गाड़ी तो बस्ता चला चली मेरी तख्ती किताबें चली भरी गोदी से भी भली लगती थी वो माँ के दुपट्टे में साबुन की खुशबू जरा सा छुआ और शर्माई पत्ती, रगड़ना रबड़ और फिर सूंघना। खुद ही अपने चेहरे पर रंग लेना होली, और वो पतंग लूटने के लिए दौड़ना। बड़ी देर मुंह खोले भीगते रहे कि बारिश की बूंद आके मुंह में गिरे, गिरा नाक में एक मोटा सा तुबका, लगी छींक ऐसी कि होश उड़ गए। टका पाई पैसे और धीले थे, छोटी उम्र बड़े फैसले थे। उचक लेना और रेडियो को उठाकर चली आई बॉक्स को लेटर खिलाकर। बड़े हो गए जब बड़ों ने कहा ये छोटा है अंदर उतर जाएगा। बचपन की यादों को फिर से बहाओ, बड़ी चटपटी है ये फिर से पिलाओ।
पेपर बोट ड्रिंक्स एंड मेमोरीज।
So it's a tough thing to communicate authenticity, and we kept on searching for what ways to do it, and this is probably, you know, one way of doing it, like, you know, use the innocent tools, use Mulberry Days. But it's very, very tough to live up to it, right? If you show something like this, your product has to live up to it. If your products are not worth it, then people would reject it vehemently. Like, you know, their rejection would be far more vehement than any otherwise. So that's when we take, I think the core of our company is about making products which live up to this authenticity. I'll give an example of Amras, which is one of our higher selling SKU and one of my favorite forever. So when we first started making it, it took us like almost 1 year for, you know, sometimes we're not getting the aroma right, sometimes we're not getting the taste right. And then we were always worried, why is happening? And we realized that all the mangoes in this countries were ripened in ethylene chambers. And this is something which started happening like 15, 20 years back, like somebody invented this ethylene chambers and everybody started putting the mangoes in there. It ripens up in 2 days instead of 14, 15 days otherwise it'll take. And then we said that probably that's the reason, and that's not the case when you do it, in your back garden. So that's when we were slightly worried that, you know, is that probably the reason why it's not happening? So we started making our mangoes as naturally ripening mangoes. And in this whole technology filled world, there was very high technology required, which was like you put all your mangoes in a heap of straw or something and keep turning them every second day. And you keep doing it for next 15 days. And that's how you get the right mangoes for your drink. And we first started doing it with 100 tons of mangoes. It was easy. Some producer in Andhra agreed to do it for us because they said, everybody said you're crazy, like you're trying to do it this way. This is age-old fashion, like nobody does it now. But we said we want to do it this way. And then first time was 100 tons of mango, second year was 500 tons. This year we're doing 10,000 tons of mango. And all of our company for last 2 months being the mango season is like trying to do this, turn the mangoes upside down every second day. Like, you know, there's like actually literally thousands of people involved in doing that right now. And we are like, you know, there's a, so IIT Kanpur, head of mechanical department, So one day I was in one of these gardens, and he was sitting there with three of his students, and with their like clocks and other stuff, trying to match like how much time a lady takes to turn the thing. Should they sit facing each other or backwards? But the it's for us, that's the maximum use of technology in our this thing. Like, how do you try to ripen your mango naturally? But it's fascinating. Like, you know, the point is, when you use authenticity to communicate to your consumer on your product has to back it up. If your product doesn't back it up, then you fail. One example where we failed is this product called Panakam. People from South India here? Like, yeah, so there's some. And so three states have, Panakam is a dish which is consumed on Ram Navami. Three states have three different recipes, Andhra, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. And when we started making Panakam, like, it takes us 2.5 years to develop a product. Like, we started researching it, and it takes 2.5-3 years to develop a product. So when we started making Panakam, we started going around temples, the drink which is made in temples, and trying to get the recipes from different places. We found three states have three different recipes. Like, Andhra is slightly peppery, Tamil Nadu is slightly gingery, and Karnataka is sweet. Like, more or less like the people there are there in these three states. So you have these three recipes, and we being from, like, some of us have engineering background, and there's the, like, you know, you want to make the perfect drink, best panakam this world has ever seen. Koi bana nahi paya dobara aur na bana payega, like, hum aisa panakam banayenge. Like, you are, like, all charged up. And then what you do is, you have these three nodes and you engineering brain, and you say, ki, I'll find the center point, you know. So I'll find the center point where the distance from three nodes is the least, and that will be the perfect thing. Like, but in food, engineering doesn't work, and we fail. Like, we launched the product, people liked that you're launching it, but they were like, lot of gully. Tambrams were so aggressively, like, you're spoiling our culture, this is not the Panakam, all of that. Like, you know, massive amount of backlash. And we were taken aback. This is small quantities we were making, and we are making it for winning the hearts of the consumer, and everybody is so offended that you have, like, you know, you North Indians have come and spoiled our culture type. Like, you know, so there was a massive amount of stuff which we are facing in South India that time. But the learning from that fiasco was that if you are launching products, you have to get, if three people give you 60 scores, you're not going to succeed. Every single time three people give you 60 score, you fail. Total score is 180, but you fail. One person gives you 90, and other two give you 20 each, that's fine. Like, your overall score is 130. But you have to have somebody who says, I love you. Like, three people saying, I like you, doesn't work. Like, you know, somebody has to say, I love you, that's the only way to survive. So in food, authenticity is very critical for any brand. Whatever you communicate on your, as a brand, on your media, you have to live up to it with your product. If you are not, it's not only about communication. Like, if you cannot, like, say something and then your product is not living up to it, you would fail. There's another video talking about what we compete with.
इस नए कॉमिक को अच्छे से पढ़ के जाऊंगा फिर एक दो कहानी मैं भी नानी को सुनाऊंगा बोगी जो इतना थरथरा रही थी कहीं मुझे गिराने का प्लान तो नहीं बना रही थी डगमगाते बोगी को चकमा देके आया फिर अनजान शक्लों ने रास्ता दिखाया सफर की दूरी कितनों को मिलाती थी साथ चलते चलते पटरियों की भी दोस्ती हो जाती थी।
कृपया ध्यान दीजिए, पुणे से चलकर नागपुर जाएंगे।
धीरे धीरे चलने की आवाज आ रही है, ये ट्रेन पापा को छोड़ के क्यों जा रही है? एक मेरा तकिया था जो भरना भूल गया, एक पापा का था जो कुछ ज्यादा ही भूल गया। आधे भरे तकिए ने बीच रात में जगाया, फिर उल्टा उतरूं या सीधा ये समझ में नहीं आया। ये चांद बिना टिकट के कहां तक आएगा? ऐसे तो ये भी नानी के घर पहुंच जाएगा। नाम भी पूछ लिया, पता भी ले लिया, पर उसका फेवरेट कलर तो पूछना ही रह गया। कोई सोया था, कोई बैठा था, कोई लेटा था, कोई खड़ा था, जगह कम थी पर ट्रेन का दिल बहुत बड़ा था।
सो द पॉइंट आई एम ट्राइंग टू मेक इज वी सी वी कंपीट विद द टफेस्ट ऑफ मेमोरी। सो नॉट ऑल ग्रैंडमदर्स वर गुड कुक्स, लाइक लेट्स एक्नॉलेज इट, लाइक सम वर रियली बैड, लाइक बट and I can like I like as a food guy, like I can compete with, I try competing with some of the grandmothers. I say ki acha tum banao main banata hu dekhte hain, and but wo like the memory of that drink is so powerful and so positive, like you don't remember the bad thing ki wo jyada namak dala tha, you don't remember that, but that food was so delicious, the memory of that food is so delicious, so every single time you serve your drink you have to compete with the memory of that drink rather than the actual what was made at that time. So it is a tougher task than actually competing with homegrown recipes. And so this is the last story which I will tell. This is about this people from North India here, right? So this kanji is a drink which we used to consume while growing up. So I was living in this compound, is a rented house. So there was a landlady, was their house was in the middle, and so we call her Mati. So Mati used to make this drink every winter. So she will get purple carrots, rye, wo matke mein bahar dhoop mein har winter mein October November. And I love that drink. Fir main wo jaake, like you try to steal something and put water in the matka to make it balance up on volume and all that. But someday you got caught up aur fir bahut pitai hui. Us time pitai karna allowed tha. And but then so then it was somewhere we moved out of that place. Mati died also, and but the memory of the drink was there with me all through, and I wanted to make this perfect drink for myself ki koi piye na piye main bana deta hu acha. And so kanji we started making like 4.5 years back, 4 years then the company started. This was one of the first few drinks which we started making, and we started, and this is the story of how we are still struggling for it right now. So this 4.5 years back, we started searching for purple carrots. There were none. So these have disappeared. Orange carrots have taken over. Purple carrots have disappeared. And so we searched around India. Kahin pe nahi mila. Not in large quantity. Ek other ton here and there, but nothing massive. Then we searched around the world. Somebody told me it's available in Poland and Turkey. I landed in Turkey, in southern Turkey, small airport called Adana. I land there. Go to this field, there were a lot of purple carrots. I was very, very happy. Like, I was like, oh, that's good. Like, you got so much purple carrots, and there's happiness. And then you try In the evening, I went to a restaurant, and there was somebody drinking this purple colored drink there. It's called Salgam. And I was intrigued. I told him to give me a glass. I tasted it exactly like how my Mati made it. And so that drink traveled from Turkey along the Silk Route. Somebody made it there, and they traveled around it. And then somebody in Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, all the places, people started making it. So I was very happy, over the moon, bought a lot of purple carrots and put it in two large suitcases and was bringing back to Delhi. And I was caught in Delhi airport by the customs guys. You can't take livestock and live feed, etc. And I was mere gajne chori ho rahi hai, I can't let it happen. And I was like, first reaction being from Haryana is to fight. You want to do that. Bhai kit khaya re, jugaad kar le. But then that guy is like very straightforward, saying you can't allow it. There is a directive, there is mad cow disease outbreak in Europe. We can't allow it. The airline is coming from that side. And like, so this was a massive blow. Aakhri mein main rone ko ho raha hu ki meri gaadne de do, so I have to make kanji. But then finally we realized, I came back and I realized that this is not the right way of doing it. So you have to do something else. And then we started getting seeds from Turkey, and we started sowing the seeds in three states. We started in Himachal, MP, and Uti. For 17 cycles, we kept on sowing the seeds and kept on filling. One cycle is, generally take 3 months. But you start every one and a half months, you start the cycle. So you fail. Sometimes the crop is not blowing, flower is not happening. But they keep persisting to the point of craziness. Ki nahi, mere ko to authentic kanji banani hai. And you can't make it with like shalgam or like the substitute which some people use. So we don't want to make it. We want to make it purple cash. That's going on. And finally, we succeeded in getting the crop in Uti. And we made the kanji, and then FSSAI, they were all confused, what is this? There's some bit of fermentation in it, all that. So they took their own time. And then when finally we got that approval also, and finally we started making it, and then everything puffed, like this last winter. So we were not able to sell it, something went wrong. And now we will try it again next year. So it's going on for last 4 years. But the point is that if you are communicating authenticity to your consumers through that, train journey and through Malgudi days and through your memories, then your product has to live up to it. And if you don't, then you fail. And every single moment of your existence should be trying to live up to the message which you are passing on to your consumer. And this is the last video, and then can you play this one, please?
हम होंगे कामयाब, हम होंगे कामयाब, हम होंगे कामयाब एक दिन. हो मन में है विश्वास, पूरा है विश्वास, हम होंगे कामयाब एक दिन. Thank you. आज एक दिन
Neeraj, thank you so much for sharing with us that authentic story. And we wish that the paper boat travels across the oceans. And thank you for sharing with us your story of how memories meet technology and you can truly change the world. And thank you for the narrating the tale of the magic purple carrots. You know, I've heard it 3 times so far, but honestly, I can hear it for another 10 times. Ladies and gentlemen, can we hear it for Neeraj Kakkar? And before I let you go, we'd like to present you a token of our gratitude. I'd like to request Jeffrey Duchess to please do the honors, sir. Fantastic. Thank you so much.